Hello everyone, in this series of Python with machine learning programming, again I welcome you. And in this tutorial today, we are going to discuss an important module that basically works on the data manipulation, and that actually is a NumPy. NumPy, although we have discussed some more type of memory which deals with the data, like list, like tuples, like dictionary, but these all were the fundamental one. So today I'm going to discuss with the NumPy, that is known as that can be expanded as the numeric Python library. And this module actually works for the data manipulation. And there are some reasons that why in the machine learning, why for analyzing the data in the data science and the machine learning, we generally recommend this NumPy module. So where I'm going to explain this to you in this channel or in this tutorial today. So I request everyone, those who haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe it so that the regular notification can be given to you. So we'll start with this NumPy module that actually I'm going to explain in an easiest way, that what are the basic operation that which we can apply over the particular data for you using for the machine learning and the data science. So I'm going to start with this one. So here we have this, first of all, the life cycle of the data. Earlier, if you just observe this one, that is the early phase of the data, that means discovering the data. Suppose that I'm making a program, I'm working on any project and I'm looking forward for some good type of data set. So I'll discover first of all that what can be the useful data for me. That means what? Discovering the data. Then in next one, then I'll going to prepare the data. And preparing the data means what? I will download this data from any data set website like Kaggle.com, and then I can apply some operations over there. So that, what kind of operation basically I'm talking about basically that what are the useless labels or the headings inside that particular data set which I can remove. So that actually comes under the data preparation. And next we have this model planning. The meaning of model planning is what kind of task I have to perform with this data. That actually is the planning phase of this particular module. Then we have this model building, means after analyzing the data, after planning your project with this particular data, then I'm going to build this particular module, and then operation will apply, and at the last then we will communicate the result, and finally we will have the result with some good information, with some new information. So we can say one thing, all these steps comes under one operation, and this is the operation that is done by the data scientist. So data scientist ki agar hum job ki baat kare, to data scientist basically a one who perform all these operations in a circular way, in a cyclic way. Clear? So here today I'm going to start with my data preparation, means what kind of memory I can use to store my data. That actually is known as the data preparation or data manipulation. So I'm going to start with this data manipulation technique, and here the data manipulation technique, we have the example like NumPy. So NumPy kya hai? Ek aisi memory hai which basically is used for data manipulation over the machine learning, because we all know that machine learning works only with the data. So that means if agar data ke liye work karta hai, to how we can use this particular memory by applying these kind of techniques over there. So here we are going to start with some data manipulation technique. But so today, first of all, if we talk about this NumPy, this NumPy module comes under, supported by the Python language only. So Python is the only language we support this one. But here we have this second point, that no built-in multi-dimensional array, means that is what, we can create our own multi-dimensional array, or we can say we can create our own n-dimensional array over there. Clear? Then we have this NumPy, that is fast in object nd array, which is a multi-dimensional array of a homogeneous data type. So I'm going to start first about this NumPy array, that how it is going to work in the particular system. So here we have this one. So I'm going to switch over this particular, particular way to understand this NumPy. So my topic is NumPy. So here we can define our topic. So here we have this topic like NumPy that is known as a numerical Python. So let's start with the system that how it works actually. So suppose that we have a kind of memory. So that is a kind of memory we are getting. That is actually, I'm taking the example of a NumPy. So here we have, this is a kind of continuous memory which I am talking about right now. Clear? So we can say, let's say I'm having this, I'm using this NumPy module, and in this we are using a type of memory in which is continuous. That means the first location is 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, and then the last one is 4. Although we have we have discussed this one in the list also, that list also contains the same type of format. But now the thing is that this continuous memory, I'm using this term named as continuous. So yahan pe main continuous ka use kar raha hu. So continuous type of memory, continuous memory. What is the meaning of this continuous memory right now? The meaning is that if this location is 0, if this location is 0, that will be confirm 1, then that 2, then 3, and then 4. In this way we can categorize this one. If you talk about the list, list again is a type of continuous memory. Lekin ek difference hai. The difference is, suppose that this is a way to define a list, and I'm using the list with the element like 1, 2, and then 3. Now we cannot use this continuous memory term for the list. So if suppose that this is my list right now, agar ye meri list hai, and these are some continuous blocks over there, memory, RAM, to kuch aisa hai, but the first element is stored in this location, second element is stored in this location, the last element has been stored in this location. So this is basically a diagram of a list. Here we have this location as 0. Logically this location will be considered as 1, and then this location will be considered as 2. But if you just imagine this condition, there are some vacant void blocks over there. But if you are using a list, we say first location is 0, so that data will be L of 0, that will be L of 1, that will be L of 2. So that actually is a way that how we can differentiate, how we can explain a list in terms of memory. But if you talk about this NumPy memory is basically the arrangement of the cell in the continuous way. And here suppose that this is a continuous location right now, ye continuous memory hai. So there will be no vacant or void cell in between. Means if suppose that I'm going to define this variable A, I'm naming this memory as A, so that will be A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, and A of 4. There will be no gap or no void cell in between, but list may contain these kind of void cell in between. Clear? So this continuous memory then in case known as array. So here I'm going to define this one. So NumPy is a module which generally creates some kind of memory, and these memories are known as arrays. So that actually is an arrays term. So arrays is what, how we can define this term arrays. So arrays is basically a type of continuous memory which is being maintained, which is implemented by this NumPy module, and then this memory contains the consecutive cell or the continuous cell. The meaning of continuous cell is technically there will be no void cell between this particular entire memory. So that means what? That is the benefit actually. The benefit over there then we'll discuss in the later on topic. So here we have, that is the comparison between list and arrays memory wise. So we can say memory wise to list ka comparison hai arrays ke saath, that actually is the comparison of list and arrays. But what, after watching this kind of memory diagram of list and arrays, kya performance mein change aayega, that practically I am going to demonstrate in this session today. So stay tuned with my channel. Now here we have this one. So yes, but if you talk about this NumPy is a module by which we can create some memories, and these memories are known as these are the consecutive memories, however, but they are known as the arrays. But we have this classification of the arrays. So already every language supports this classification. And if you talk about this classification, the thing is that the first one is 1D array. and the meaning of 1D array is like vector. Vector means what? If you are going to store the data in the vector form or in the same or in the single row, that is known as the 1D array. Clear? So that is axis of 0. Axis of 0 means what? There is only one row over there. Now the second category of the array is the two-dimension array. And this two-dimension array is basically what? It is the arrangement of row and column and putting the data over there. So that means what? It is a kind of matrix. So matrix ka jo implementation we generally use to store the data, and that is actually the 2D array. Here we can say one thing, axis 0 denotes what? That denotes the rows, and axis 1 denotes the number of columns over there. Then we have the 3D array, and this 3D array contains what? It contains the, this is the actual way, the number of columns and then number of rows, number of columns and number of rows, and then we define what? We define the way that how many rows and columns, how many sets we can prepare over there. That actually is the meaning of this particular one. So we can say one thing, this is the kind of row. So axis 0 is showing the rows, axis 1 is showing the column, and axis 2 is showing actually that how many this kind of combination we are creating over there. So right now today I'm going to discuss about this 1D array and 2D array. Clear? So here we have this one. But one important point is, when we define any array, either I'm defining the 1D array, 2D array, or 3D array, the data should be of homogeneous type. Homogeneous means what? Same type of data. If I'm going to store here as a number 7, so there, that is the integer type of data. So here I have to define the number, and that will be, that must be an integer value. That again will be the integer value, that again will be the integer value. And if you talk about this one, if suppose that in the first location we are storing the data as 7.2, so next location maybe we can store float type of value, float type of value, float type of value. That is the meaning of homogeneity. And if you talk about the heterogeneity, list is a type of memory which can store the dissimilar or heterogeneous type of data element in the consecutive order. But that consecutive, actually we, it seems that that is a consecutive one, but actually practically consecutive nahi hota hai. Clear? So here we have this one. So today in this tutorial we will start with the best comparison of Python list versus NumPy array. That what actually the difference between these two memory, and why we are focusing more on this NumPy right now, why not than list? If already we have discussed about the list, so why there is a need of using this NumPy array? So that actually is the question, and we have the justification. Practically we'll justify this statement. So the first one is, yes, processing performance. And the meaning of processing performance is, for same kind of situation where we have the same kind of data is stored in list and one the same kind of data is stored in the NumPy array, the thing is that how we can differentiate it, how the processing performance can vary between these two one, that we are going to discuss today. So according to the experimental result, it has been observed that yes, this rabbit will be the NumPy array and this tortoise will be the list for the same kind of situations over there. That means what? We can say one thing, that that will perform best in processing performance case. The next we have this memory management. And if we talk about the memory management, the same kind of data if I'm going to store in my program, so which of the data, which of the memory will work well, which of the memory will consume the less memory? Because we all know one thing, that less memory take less time to execute the program, and that will be the best program actually. So that means what? Memory management, maybe if any of the memory which will take less memory for the same data set, that will be considered to be the best one. So that also we are going to demonstrate. Next we have this mathematical operation, and in this mathematical operation we'll again discuss one thing, that for the same kind of operation, which of the memory will perform well. So that actually also we have to check over there. So here for this experimental result of comparing this list in Python and NumPy in Python, I'm going to use my Google Colab. So Google Colab is basically what? It is a cloud-based service given by the Google, and that particular ID, that particular editor of the Python support almost all kind of packages which we are going to use in the machine learning. So in my entire series of this machine learning, I'm going to use this Google Colab in my, for the experimental results. So here I'm going to switch over this particular one. So we'll see that. So first of all, your basic approach will be, you have to type Google Colab. Then after typing this Google Colab, the very first link that will, that we have to click on. Now it will ask me for the new notebook. So I'm going to click over the new notebook, and then it will take some time, and then finally it will be opened. So here is the welcome screen of this Google Colab. Now It will take a few seconds, then it will load all the modules in my particular program right now. So that basically what I'm doing right now, I'm using the cloud service for this Python IDE, clear? So my first task is that I have to save my program. So here my program is list versus NumPy. So here we have list oblique, yeah, versus we can use NumPy. An extension will be given as ipynb. In the previous Python IDE, we generally use .py, but here I'm going to use that ipynb, clear? So now we'll start with this one. So the very first part is that we have to compare our system. So my first program is what? We have to compare the performance of NumPy and list memory. So we'll start with this one. So for this, first of all, we have to use this two module. The first one is how to import the module of NumPy. I'm going to use this import NumPy, and then I'll define one object, and that object can be user defined, but I'm going to define over here as np. So np is my object, and by this object then I can access all the functions of this NumPy. So import NumPy as np, and my second module is import a time, yes, because we have to check the calculator, we have to check the performance of these two memories. So I'm going to use this one now. So here we have this one. So now if I have to run this one, because I have to upload these two modules in my program right now, so either I can go with the runtime option, run all, that is worst way to use, and or the second option is to run these two statements. I can use the shortcut key control and enter. So here I'm going to click over there. It will take a few seconds, and then when this processing will stop, that means what? If no error is coming, that means already we have used the proper method of importing the NumPy module in the time module. So it is taking some time, but finally now the work has been done, no error is here. So now main shell ko shift karta hun. I'm going to use one more shell over there. Even I can use in the same cell, or I can extend my cell, I can integrate my program. So first of all, my first one is I'm going to create a list. So first of all, we all know that how to create a list, but the main thing is that randomly how we are going to create a list with n numbers. So I'm going to use my list, and that is actually we can say l one equals to list range, and then we have this 1000. So I'm going to define, the best part will be I should define one variable size with the value as 1000, and then we have this list range 1000. Now list range, that is size. Now the meaning of this statement is, the meaning is the list L1 has been created with size 1000. So that is the size. By default, there is no need to assign the values over there. Automatically size will be created. We can verify over there. I'm going to run this program. You just check it out. What should be the value of L1? So these are the values of L1. The last part has been shown over there. Otherwise, we have the values from 1 up to the 999. That is the last value over there. So that actually is the way how I'm going to use this L1 list. So again, the next one is I'm going to use this L2. So L2 come use karenge, and then the same method list. Then I'm going to define another list range, and then we have the element, and these elements are the same. So that means what? Here I have created the another list L2. Clear? Now I'm going to start my timer. That we all know that how to calculate the performance of a time, performance of the state, performance of the program. That should be done by this timer statement. So here we have start equals to, and then we have this one of time dot time. Already I have imported this time module, so time dot time. That will start the time from this particular line. So now we have to make a module. What I want actually right now, I want that addition of these two L1 and L2 should be stored in a variable. So if I'll do L1 plus L2, that will concatenate these values. So I don't want to concatenate the values. Actually, I have to store this value. So here I'm going to use result equals to and then I'll use a statement that will be like x comma y, then for x comma y in, yes, I'm going to use a gif function. Well, the purpose of this gif function is that actually performs the addition part. Means what actually is going on, this L1 and L2 are being combined in a single unit, and then the result will be stored in the result variable. So that is basically the way of adding addition of lists elements. So that actually is the way that how we are going to add the list elements. So this is actually the way of adding the list elements, clear? So now the work has been done. Now that was a simple task that how I can use this gif function. The meaning of gif function is to combine the different list, and that will be taken as a variable as x and y. In x and y it will be stored, and then that will be finally, that is going to be stored in the result condition. So that actually is the way. Now I'm going to print my result. So my result will be, yes, now that was the initial time when the program is going to start. From here it is going to run, that will be the start value. Now I'm going to start with the, I'm going to calculate the time of the list. So list time, that is the list time taken for this addition. List time taken for this addition. So now we have this one, or that will be defined by time dot time minus start, clear? And then that will be multiplied by 1000, because the value I'm getting will be in microsecond. So I want to convert this timing into the second zone. That's why I'm using it by multiplying it by 1000. So here I'm going to run my program, then we'll see that what actually is the result over there. Yes, now this list addition of this L1 and L2 is taking approximate 1.45 something time over there. So that actually is the way how to calculate the timing, time taken by the particular addition of these two lists, clear? So now I'm going to start with my next shell, and now here we will have, so now that can vary student, but the main thing is that the initial value was the first one to print the result over there. So chaliye main isi mein start karta hu isme. So now again I'm going to create one more. Now I'm going to create a 1D array. So 1D array mein the first array is ARR1, and that will be used by np.arrange. So what actually is np.arrange? That is same like the np dot, that is same like the range function. So here I'm going to define this size over there. Next we have my ARR2, and that will be defined by np.arrange, and then again I'm going to define this, the value of size. We can define this in the short way that this is a way, method to assign an array with some range, okay? So that actually is the way. In my part 2 also I'll define this one, that what how it is working right now. So now I have to perform the operation of addition. So before that I have to start my timer. So here we have to start my timer. So start equals to that will be time dot time, time dot time, clear? Now again then we will print this value. So addition will be done by, I'm going to use this my result underscore 2. So let's say that is my new variable result underscore 2, and that will store the value. So that will be done by A1 addition of these two will be done by ARR1 plus ARR2. That is the way how the addition will perform over there. Now after that, after addition, the task has been done. Now we have to calculate the performance time over there. So here we have this condition, the performance time. So numpy time, so here I will define this one. So that will be time dot time, and then that will be subtracted by start, and then this will be multiplied by 1000, because I have to know the result in the seconds. So that's why we have used this one. So now again I'm going to run this program, then we'll see that what actually is the result over there. So now just check it out over there. Okay, now there is some change over there, and numpy timing is actually, there is some issue with the data set. So we'll have this one. Okay, fine. So that actually is the result, because my range was so less, so 1000 element it can access, it can use within some microseconds. So that's why we have taken this one. So now just imagine this condition is from the same operation working on for both the one. Here I'm going to apply L1 and L2 with the addition part, and here I'm going to apply with the same memory I'm going to assign with the ARR1 plus ARR2. Then when both are being added in some different scenarios, their time is, you just check the performance time over there. So I think there is a gap of these 2 seconds of gap is there. So this is a way that how we can imagine that, yes, how we can consider that, yes, this particular NumPy memory is faster as compared with the list for the same kind of scenario. Clear? So this is the way. Now our second one is, so we have to compare the memory. Yes, the memory. So memory ko we are going to compare. So for that, I'm going to import one more module, and that module is what actually does module is sys module. Sys module is a system module, and that actually work for getting the, to calculate the memory size of some variable. Either it can be a list or either it can be the normal variable. So here we have this one. So that will be sys. So I'm going to run this program first. So that will take some time. Okay, then that means what, automatically the sys module has been uploaded for the, for my program. So that module is used for calculating the memory size. So clear? Memory size of some variable. So here we have this one. So now we'll start with this memory comparison. So for this, we have already imported this particular sys module. So first of all, I'm going to assign a memory. So let's say I'm going to use a memory, and that memory is L3, the new one, list. And then I'm going to assign a range over there, and that range will be size. Okay, we have taken the earlier in the, we have taken the size value as 1000. So that actually is the value of 1000. So I'm going to assign it over here as 1000. Okay, that will remain as 10,000. I'm going to newly, then I'm going to create this value of size. So that will be size equals to 1000. Clear? Now here we have L3 equals to list, and range will be size. And again, we have one more variable. Okay, fine. Then we have to calculate the memory size of one only. Now I'm going to create one ARR3. That is one array. That will be numpy.arrange. Arrange function I'll discuss in the my part 2 video. And I'm going to define it as a size only. So now just consider one thing, both the functions, both the memories, L3 list and this array as ARR3, both have the same size of 1000. So now we have to calculate it, both are from both of them, which will occupy the less memory and which will occupy the more memory. So first of all, already we know if you want to access these elements over there, it can be easily displayed over there. So now first of all, I'm going to calculate the size of the list. So size of the list, let's say I'm taking list underscore size. Now that will be calculated by sys dot get size. So get size is basically a function, get size of is basically a function which is defined under the sys module, and that generally identify the memory size, that generally return the memory size of the particular variable which we are going to pass over there. Clear? So now we have to, let's say I'm going to define, now this is a list actually, this L3 is a list, and if L3 is a list, it has a location, it has the number of cell as 1000. So right from L3 of 0 to L3 of 999, we have this location. So any other location I can give, so I want to know this particular size over there. And then that will be multiplied by the length of the total length of this particular L of 3. So L of 3 ki jo total length hai, that will be multiplied by this one. So now this will be the way that how we are going to calculate the size of this list L3, and the result will be stored in the list underscore size. Clear? Now next we have what? Now next we have to calculate the size of the array. So here we have ARR underscore size. Now I'm going to start with this one. So that will be what? That will be, the name is ARR3, my array's name. And then that will be multiplied by the size. So size is a function which is going to calculate the entire size of this particular array. And now that will be multiplied by ARR dot item size. That means what actually, you just understand this condition right now. This item size is the size of each item, and this ARR size is what actually, it is the total number of cell available over there. So total number of cell multiplied by the item size will give you the exact location, exact value or exact the memory size in bytes. it is going to give in bytes. So now I'm going to display my result, and my first result is size of list memory. And the size of the list memory is stored into the variable list underscore size. So here we have this one. Yes, that is this one. And it actually is in the bytes. So we can define this term bytes over there. Now the next one is we have to calculate the size of this NumPy. So here we have size of NumPy memory. NumPy array memory. AMOMORY. NumPy arrays memory, and then that will be calculated by, then here we have this condition. So here we have this arr underscore size, and then that again is a value that will be in terms of bytes only. So here we have this value. So this is the way that how we are going to calculate the memory size. Now I'm going to run my program. Okay, fine. So there is some error, and the error is arr size equals to arr dot size multiplied by ARR3. Okay, one problem is there. Here I forgot to mention the ARR3. My variable name is ARR3. And yes, rest of things are okay. So now we'll run this program. You just observe one thing, students. List memory is occupying 28 bytes. And then this one is occupying 800 bytes. There is some problem with this particular list right now. Just wait a minute. Fine. There is some problem. Okay. L3 of 5 multiplied by. That will be get size of. Okay. Just wait a minute. There is some problem over there. Get size of, I can use this term 5 over there. It again can give me the result. Multiply by length. Okay. Okay, fine, students. So that actually was a mistake I was doing. So get size of 5. 5 means any number, because we are using a list ranging from 0 to 999. So 5 can be a number. So we have to calculate the location size where the number 5 has been stored, multiplied by the total length of the list, and that will calculate the size over there. Same as we have calculated for the list, for the arrays, one cell size multiplied by the total number of cell that will give. Now you just compare the size. 800 bytes has been taken by from the same memory, but for the list it has taken approximate 28,000 bytes. So there is a huge gap between these two. So we can say one thing, which one is best in that particular case. The thing is, we have this particular, yes, we have this what? We have this array, NumPy array, as a best one, because it is occupying 800 bytes of memory for this size of 1,000 cell. But this list is occupying 28,000 bytes for this 1,000 cell. Clear? So here we have this one. Now, if we talk about the next one, the next thing is that mathematical operation wise, which one is best? So I think array or NumPy array is best. I can give you the reason. The reason is, if suppose that there is a list L equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Clear? So if I have to divide each and every of the operation by 2, so I cannot do L by 2. Clear? I have to use the condition that L of 0 divided by 2, then L of 1 divided by 2, L of 2 divided by 2, and then L of 3 divided by 2. But here we have this arrays method. So let's say I'm going to define this arr, that is np dot array, and I'm going to define this 1d array, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if I have to divide all these number and I have to store in any one variable, that can be done by simply just do one thing, x equals to arr divide by 2. So that means what? That will store all the result, that will individually divide the numbers of this np array by 2, and then store in the result in the variable x. So we can say one thing, from this perspective we can say that if we have to apply the multiplication operation in the list element of integers, we have to integrate, means l of 0 by 2, l of 1 by 2, l of 2 by 2, up to l of n minus 1 by 2. But if you talk about this arr array or np array, numpy array, so we can say instead of integrating dividing by 2, just do one thing. You just take a single variable and then divide it by 2. The entire element will be easily divisible by 2. So that actually is the way that how we are going to use this comparison. So from this, we have understood one thing, that if you compare this Python list versus NumPy, NumPy we can use for our machine learning projects. Why? Because in my future videos, we'll discuss that only the NumPy we can use for some of the numerical analysis of data. Because of these reasons, the performance, because we have to concern with the performance. Right now, I have taken off 1000 memory of cell I have taken, where the data has been stored over there. But in the future cases, we'll discuss some more kind of data set jahan par we will have the millions of data of the same time. Then this millions of data needs a performance also. That's why these millions of data will be stored in my NumPy memory instead of using this list. And even same for the memory, because memory is being maintained by the what? It is being maintained by the less memory is maintained by the NumPy for the thousand of cell as compared with the list. That's why less memory will increase the performance of the program, and that will be efficient program. So that's why we are going to recommend, in both the cases we are going to recommend this NumPy memory over there. So I think this topic is clear to you all. There are some topics that how we are use this range function and arrange function and what is NP. So in my part 2 of this NumPy series, I'm going to explain these all one. But basically the part 1 was that how to do the comparison between the NumPy and the list. That's why in short I have taken this one. So I'll recommend that you must watch this my part 2, so that every basic command should be clear to you that how we can manipulate the data with the NumPy analysis. Clear? So thank you everyone, and thank you for your keen listening. Thank you. Have a nice day.